We created the City Energy Analyst tool with a big objective in mind, and that was to help us understand how to plan the low carbon city.
We would like to empower planning teams with methods and tools necessary to improve the efficiency of cities in an affordable and secure way by open sourcing all our material and tools such as the City Energy Analyst. We would also like to empower researchers to connect to and build on the state-of-the-art faster than ever before.
The technology I'll be focusing on is on thermal networks. In Singapore, it's district cooling, as you know. And I want to look into how can I combine the new advances in the building systems and to integrate it into the district level to provide more efficient way to supply our energy.
I think that optimization is very appealing because not many tools, not many simulation tools are capable. CA can create graphs very quickly, and this is also very handy and useful.
One of the most interesting module that I felt within this CA tool, it's the auto generation of the network for the district cooling, which is very, very useful. I've never seen this kind of feature in other softwares. So it actually plans out the network, size up your pipes, gives you the losses. Effectively, you can actually call a tender after this simulation.
We could come up using the CEA tool, the most optimized solution with effect from carbon emission, cost and social sustainability for low carbon cities.
Today we're here for the workshop with the City Energy Analyst, which is an important milestone of our research here at the Future Cities Lab in Singapore. We are happy and for the next 5 days to have practitioners and other researchers to get their hands on these type of tool sets and work on different case studies for exploring this interrelation of energy supply for future low carbon cities and potential implications on architectural and urban design.
This has a really important thing on the way we do research and also development in what it concerns to energy systems research, because we help also that researchers transfer their knowledge back to practice and to decision makers in a faster pace.
I think this diverse mix will be very helpful to understand the different aspects of designing this type of future systems.